Ricardo, Nick, congratulations. You guys have made it into the final round of this competition. Now we're sending you back to your home forges to recreate this iconic weapon from history. The Ikakalaka. Forged by the Mongo tribe in the Kingdom of London during the early 1800s, the Ikakalaka was a fierce and imposing weapon. Designed for executions, the double-edged blade featured a thick spine and large crescent tip, giving it the ability to forcibly chop with ease. This powerful weapon with an ornate shape quickly became associated with wealth, dignity, and social position among men and women in the Mongo tribe. The Ikakalaka can be seen in the 2018 blockbuster film, Black Panther. The length of the blade must be between 19 and 21 inches, and you must have an hourglass-shaped handle.
I am nervous because I've never forged something like that before. It's a kind of sword that I can't even pronunciate the name.
You'll have just 4 days at your home forges in which to complete this blade. At the end of that time, you'll return and present your Ikakalakas to our panel of expert judges. And after they've smashed and bashed and cut and thrust with them, they'll declare one of you guys the Force and Fire champion and hand you a check for $10,000. Good luck. We'll see you in 4 days.
It's day one, and today I have to build an Ikakalaka sword. The goal for today is to get the crescent head on here, because that way, if there is a mess up, I'll be able to address it. I cut the 80CRV at an angle to establish my scarf weld so that when I stack those billets up together, I'm going to try and mold those down into the original blade to make a crescent. All right, slowly but surely. Into day one, all the forge welds are good. I'm tired, but I'm feeling very good. Looking pretty good.
It's a day one, and I'm going to take care of the Ikakalaka and Hakuna Matata for everybody. I'm going to start forging the length and forging the body of the blade. Then I'm going to make that weird tip. I'm using water on the anvil just to make the tip a little cooler. This is a very old technique to give me the control to make the shoulders better. The tip is done. Time to get into the oil.
That's hard.
So far, I'm happy. Yes!
It's the morning of day two. Plan is move a lot of steel, get this thing shaped, hopefully quenched. It's gonna be a big, heavy blade. The weapon was made as a serious chopper. It will be heavy, but when you get it in your hands, it will be a commanding tool. I'm gonna make sure our quench tank is gonna accept this. It's maybe a quarter inch too small. Before I can quench, I have to modify my quench tank. Let's give it a shot, see where we're at. Well, I thought that, you know, squishing the quench tank was gonna go easier, but it took valuable time out of my day.
That's pretty good.
The time is definitely an issue here, so I have to get this thing quenched. I think we're pretty good. I'm elated. It's straight, so I'm feeling great right now.
Today is day three. I have a blade that's good to turn in, but I think I can do better. So let's turn on the forge and start over. I love so much this job that I'm making twice. What took me hours before, it just took me minutes this time. And now I'm done. I love when a plan comes together. I quench the second blade. The blade is straight, it's hard, sounds good for me. I still need to decide which one I'm gonna send to the judges.
It's the morning of day four, and today we gotta get a handle on this thing. So I'm gonna take the black walnut, I'm gonna start working it up. We've got to get this hourglass design into it. We're gonna put our butt cap on, our pommel cap, and then we're gonna weld it and attach it up so that it'll be strong and tight and ready to go. I want the end of my handle to be protected as much as I can. I've got everything all together, so now just comes really working on that edge as much as I can. I feel a tremendous weight lifted off of my shoulders.
Today is the last day, and I'm much more confident in the second project. So the second one is the one I'm gonna compete with. What I did different in this blade, it has a different edge geometry and a harder temper. Everything is coming together. Now it's time to go and see how does it gonna perform. For me, it's okay. I'm happy.
Ricardo, Nick, you boys have had 4 days at your home forges to work on your finale weapons. Ricardo, tell the judges about your blade.
I used a truck spring to make that because I'm used to work with that kind of material. It has 19 inches long and has one hand handle, so I'm pretty happy with that.
All right, Nick, tell the judges about your blade.
It's hand forged from a 5160. It's got a San Mai on the crescent, etched up. Black walnut handle, and I put some African symbolism on there to symbolize humility and strength.
Gentlemen, there will be three tests. There will be a strength test, a sharpness test, and up first, Doug, and the kill test.
All right, bladesmiths, welcome to the kill test. Well, your Ikakalakas look interesting and exotic, but what kind of lethal damage can they do? Well, to find that out, I'm gonna take your weapon, deliver some lethal blows on this ballistics dummy. Ricardo, you're first. You ready?
Yes, sir. I'm ready. Let's go for it.
I feel like my heart is going to blow out my chest because you never know what's going to happen. This is the moment. This is what I work for. This is the truth.
All right, Ricardo, I like your Ikakalaka.
Thank you.
It's got a good weight to it. The handle construction is comfortable. When you're swinging in this, it digs deep. That is a sharp edge. And when you're penetrating, it really digs and cuts on the way out. Overall, sir, you will keel.
Thank you, sir.
All right, Nick, your turn, sir. You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do this.
Ricardo's Ikakalaka is everything I expected, light, fast, well-made weapon. But my confidence level is pretty good. I'm fairly confident that my blade will succeed.
The minute you pick up this weapon, I feel the stress on my wrist, my elbows, and my shoulder. It's so forward heavy. Tell me what you feel.
Front shoulder. I'm trying to swing this over and over. It's gonna be tough. And that's a tendon ripper monster.
And it's not looking good.
Nick, due to the extreme weight of your Ikakalaka, the judges feel that it would be unsafe to attempt to wield it in the same manner that they wielded Ricardo's one-handed blade. And because we can't test it evenly and fairly, we cannot move forward with testing. I'd like to invite you to shake our hands, shake your competitor's hand, and then please exit the forge.
Just totally disappointed.
Sorry about
that,
my friend.
I wanted them to really test that weapon. I had a lot of faith in it. I knew it was heavy, but one little mistake like this is something I'm gonna learn on and build, and it's gonna make me a better smith.
Well, Ricardo, congratulations. You are the new Forge and Fire champion, and that is the title that comes with a check for $10,000. Come on forward. Good job. That's a great weapon.
This is great. This is amazing. Being a champion is to trust what I'm doing. You can trust on my blades. I can trust on my work. I'm really, really happy to be the champion.